Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one, it's a little bit of an introductory one because I want to make a bit of a playlist, particularly on... it's a little bit of an adventure, if you like. It's a little bit of engineering, like making cogs and bits and pieces, and also electrical engineering. A little while ago, someone suggested that I try and make a generator. And so I got interested, and over the last sort of 6 months or so, I've been playing around and come up with some interesting things, and I've learned a lot of interesting things as well. And I thought it was such an adventure, which I quite enjoyed, and I thought you might like to too. So I'll show you what I've come up with so far, and then in this playlist, we'll start making or remaking a few of these things, finding out what I learned and what you might learn, or might just have fun. Now the first thing I made was this instrument here, a cog at the top to a pulley and down to a motor, which then will generate some electricity to run this LED. Now this motor here puts out 3 volts at 50 milliamps. By turning this here, I can say it's not very efficient, but at least it does actually generate electricity, just to prove the point. Now, having proven the point, I decided to go a little bit simpler. Instead of using cogs, I just used pulleys. Went from this first wooden pulley with cardboard sides to a brass strap, to a wooden pulley, down to a motor that I scavenged from a printer, and that will generate 12 volts at 40 milliamps, which is enough to run a motorbike headlamp. It's not very bright in the daylight, but it's quite decent at night. In the process, I learned things about like diodes, just to make the electricity go in one direction, and also a voltage regulator over there that I was able to make on this one, so that I could charge my cell phone on this thing. Next, I wanted to simplify it, so I just made a bigger pulley with one string to a motor on a pivoting situation so that it will generate. This generates 5 volts, this motor, and is enough to run LEDs, 20 in this case, is quite happy. Now my next one was this one here, and it is pulleys again, using a couple of CDs and some wood, some pipe and stuff. And the idea was to make things a little bit more efficient, and we did manage that. And the improved efficiency, I managed to put a rechargeable phone battery there so that it will hold a little bit of a charge, and that will give me, I think it's 8 volts at approximately 80 milliamps. And with the battery, it gives us a little bit of downtime where I don't have to wind it quite as much. It's enough to run 40 light bulbs without the battery, or 20 light bulbs with some of the time you have a hand free to open a door or pick something up. But it's about the strength of a good hand lamp that you usually have batteries with. Now the next one, I wanted to go back to simplicity again. A big wheel that I can put in a wall in a hut somewhere or something, and down to a motor. And this one's the most efficient so far. This motor gives me 8 volts at 90 milliamps, which is enough to give me almost 60 LEDs. And you spin it a little bit slower, so it's quite efficient in its simplicity. And my latest one is another repetition of the same, except for I'm improving the bearings to become more efficient, and also in the manufacture of the components, the wheels and things, and the pulleys and stuff, to become more efficient in the manufacture of them, all by hand of course, and also the implementation of a bridge rectifier so that you can then turn it in whichever direction you like, and it will still put out the current necessary for the lights. And that's in readiness for other experiments that I'll be doing. So there are some of the experiments that I've been doing over the last few months, and it's been a great fun. And so join me in further videos on this playlist of remaking some of those things so you can see what I learned and how I made them, and also more experiments to learn new stuff that I'm excited to think about. So come and join me later on.